Good morning. Good morning. Thank you, sir.
Your hobby is writing letters to the editor.
Yes, sir.
What letters do you write, or latest 2-3 letters you tell us? What the letters that you have written?
So there are some editorials and opinions are there. Based on that, I write critiques, or I favor that opinion. I write about that, sir.
Tell me last 2-3 letters. Last 1 letter or 2 letters that you have written. And what are the subjects?
Sir, there are some defection issues going on state assemblies. I wrote regarding that. There is one to, we have to change the power of speaker regarding anti-defection law. I wrote regarding that, sir.
What is the Supreme Court's latest opinion on that?
Sorry, sir?
What is Supreme Court's latest opinion on that?
Sir, Supreme Court wanted some other collegium based mechanism to decide.
Tribunal, a tribunal.
Yes, sir. To decide on the defection cases, sir.
Okay. You have taken political science as optional. Why?
Sir, my UG degree is not available as optional, sir. And I also interested in studying about the origin of states and the concepts like rights, equality, and also it provided a wide range of subjects like history of India and politics of India. So I chose that, sir.
Okay. You are interested in reading equality?
Yes, sir.
What is the reasonable classification?
Sorry, sir?
Reasonable classification. What is that?
I am not getting.
Recently, it is being discussed so much. While the Home Minister replied on the Citizenship Amendment
Act.
Yes,
sir.
Tell what is that?
Sir, Citizenship Amendment Act was amended recently to provide a fast-track citizenship to religious minorities from six religious minorities in our neighboring countries like Pakistan, Afghanistan and Bangladesh, sir.
But what is reasonable classification? My question was that. What is reasonable classification based upon intelligible differentia? Have you heard of these words?
No, sir.
But they have been so much discussed in every newspaper almost.
Okay, sir.
They have written.
I will look into it, sir.
Okay. Article 14 tells about equality.
Yes, sir.
But equality is not mathematical equality. There will be reasonable classification of a group which are below.
Okay.
So they have to, so it's called positive discrimination.
Okay, sir.
They can be taken. That is reasonable classification.
Okay, sir.
So regional classification has to be based upon an intelligible difference.
Yeah? Okay, sir.
There are the two phrases which are being discussed everywhere. What is the third phrase?
Sorry, sir.
There is a third phrase also.
Okay.
Let's look at this. What is the third?
So I am not getting you properly, sir. Sorry, sir.
Regional classification based upon intelligible difference. Yeah? And it must have a rational nexus of the policy to the ill that you are seeking to better. There are three phases which are
okay.
See, you are Priyanka, your interest in options subject, you have taken political science and international relations. But your basic graduation is from engineering.
Yes, sir.
International relations in the present day, can you please tell us three important issues dominating the international relations today?
So the first thing is trade war between China and USA, sir. And the second thing is the issue with Iran and US. They have recently taken a military attack over a military official of Iran, sir. And the third thing is climate change issue, where developing countries and developed countries are in tussle, sir.
So climate change is, in your view, is the third one, not the first one?
No, sir. I didn't given a priority. I am saying these three issues, sir.
Okay, you know, the two countries have expressed their reservations in strong terms. Almost bordering, condemning India on abrogation of Article 370 and CIA. Can you name those two countries?
Sir, one is Malaysia, sir.
Good.
And China also, in initial time, they have...
Not a superpower.
Okay, sir. I'm not sure about it, sir.
Turkey.
Okay, sir.
Okay, you mentioned about Malaysia.
Yes, sir.
Correct. And government of, what was Government of India's response to Malaysia? And the Government of India's response and the Malaysian government's stand on CAA, 370 and CAA. Its own Tamil Nadu connection. Has affected Tamil Nadu also. Can you tell us?
Sir, Indian government has responded that it's their internal affairs. So they didn't want to express other countries their opinion into.
No, my question is not that. Malaysia and Turkey have expressed the reservations. In fact, Malaysian Prime Minister President Mahathir has gone a few steps ahead and said that India was an occupying army in Jammu and Kashmir. And he has mentioned about CAA and strongly, you know, criticized, condemned India's
move. Yes, sir.
For which India has reacted.
Yes, sir.
And my question is that reaction has its own Tamil Nadu connection. Government of India's reaction has affected Tamil Nadu in a way. Can you tell us that issue, that particular issue?
Sir, I think they had said that if they include religion in granting citizenship or in migration, it might affect the Hindus growing from here, from Tamil Nadu to Malaysia, sir. I think they have said that.
Only that. More than that, it the decision, I repeat for the third time, the Government of India's reaction has forced Malaysia to take certain steps and India has retaliated with few steps. And those steps have got certain, a connection, it has its own connect with Tamil Nadu. In our day-to-day life.
What are those steps?
Yeah.
What is the reaction of India?
I'm not sure, sir.
Palm oil? Have you?
Yes, sir. Yes.
Palm oil?
Yes, sir.
So Indian government has discouraged private players from importing palm oil from Malaysia.
Okay, sir.
Though it is not official, directly Government of India has exerted pressure on private players importing palm oil from Malaysia.
Okay, sir.
Rather, it has advised them, nudged them to, encourage them to procure from other places.
Okay, sir.
Wherein we have to pay $10 more for
them. Okay, sir.
Now, that decision has affected Tamil Nadu's financial, already fragile financing. Finances. That is our palm oil, which you and I are getting it in PDS. The government is, the state government has been forced to give additional, adequate, sums for managing the extra.
Okay, sir.
This palm oil issue. So, this has its own connection with that Malaysia's, decision to abrogate, condemn this thing.
Okay.
And what is the reaction to Turkey?
Turkey, yeah.
India's reaction?
Sir, I'm not sure about it, sir.
Have you heard about the Cyprus issue?
Yes, sir.
Read about it.
Okay, sir. Okay.
Is it true that after this Modi 2.0, India's friction with its regional powers are increasing? These regional powers are slowly but steadily drifting towards China.
Sir, we cannot see it that way, sir, because each nation for their national interest, they want to have a good relationship with all the neighbors, especially India and China are big players in South Asia, sir. So, they are trying to balance the relationship with both, sir. It's because every nation has now focusing on their economy, so that they want good relationship with every nation. So, I didn't feel that it started after only Modi 2.0.
Could you tell us something about these Australian bushfires? Main cause for these bushfires?
Sir, I think it's mainly due to climate change where failure of monsoon has occurred in Australia. So that every time there occurs a bushfire, but due to lack of rainfall and monsoon, it happened in a large scale, which are not controlled by humans.
So, what is the present situation in Australia now? They say that they are going to kill 10,000 camels and few species which are exclusively you know, originating and living in Australia are in a very big danger. Present status. What happened to the 10,000 camels? Have they finished that off or?
I read about they are planning to kill that camels, but I am not sure what it's now.
You are aware of Swachh Bharat Mission?
Yes, sir.
Part of that, there was a Clean India Mission.
Yes, sir.
What is it all about? Is it a success or what do you think about that? The present status of that?
Sir, after the Clean India Mission, which included the mass participation of people in cleaning the surroundings, and there are toilet construction in each and every household. I feel that after Swachh Bharat, there are increased in toilet usages and toilet construction, and also people are now aware that they have to dispose the waste properly, sir. I'm seeing the changes from after the schemes.
Okay. What is the present status of it? What is government's position on that?
Thank you.
Sir, I think almost 20 plus states are now ODF free after this Swachh Bharat Abhiyan, sir.
Okay.
And also toilet construction is almost from 60% to 93% at present, sir. So I think this mission is successful and it's also performing well.
Why it is considered this open defecation? Why it is a serious problem? Why do we think it's a serious problem?
Sir, since it's connected with health of the human beings, sir, because due to defection, it leads to contamination of water, and it leads to breeding of mosquitoes and like that of things. So it will create a big health disorder, sir. So we are focusing on open defecation free, sir.
I saw reports saying that construction part of it we were greatly successful, but still habits continue. If you are administrator, what will you do on those aspect of it? Like people not using it, well, what can be done in that kind of a situation?
So here we need a behavioral change from the people. For that we have to nudge the children in the house through school awareness camps, so that the children can act as a player to instill the value in the houses. So we have to use that so that we will have a good environment. The first thing will be that one, sir, and the second thing will be better monitoring thing using the government machinery, sir. This will play a good role in making the toilet usage, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you.
I had one question related to that Sarah was asking. Swachh Bharat. It has its own links with an earlier scheme. What was it called?
So if I'm not wrong, it's Nirmal Bharat.
It's NRHM, National Rural Health Mission.
Okay, sir.
In fact, for phase, several months, the website of Swachh Bharat, if you type Swachh Bharat, it will lead you to NHR.
Okay, sir.
Last couple of months back only, they have actually removed it. Nothing
okay.
Any type. Just a cut and paste of NRHM.
Okay.
But you can't say that.
Okay, sir.
So have you heard about, like, you know, since you are talking about Swachh Bharat, heard about WASH?
Yes, sir.
What is it?
Sir, I think it's related to sanitation, health, and water facilities, sir.
So, you are talking about toilets, right?
Yes,
so
sir.
You heard about bio toilets?
Yes, sir.
So, is it successful? In Tamil Nadu particularly.
So I think this model is introduced to reduce the water consumption and also to use that waste in a useful manner. But they installed that bio toilets in many public places, sir, but the peoples are not utilizing it in proper way. So it's not, I feel it's not successful thing, sir.
What makes it successful?
So because we Indians are used to water usages, so I think that must be changed, and proper regular cleaning up method has to be included, and people has to be made aware about that bio toilets so that it will be successful.
Since you are from Anna University, CEG, right?
Yes, sir.
Now Anna University given us IOS rates. So people were telling, like, you know what is in the IOS?
Yes, sir.
So people were telling, like, they are going to split Anna University into two, like that the issues are going on. Faculties are opposing, somebody is say yes, it's good, somebody say, what is your opinion on it? As alumni of CEG.
Sir, I feel that Institute of Eminence tag is necessary for Anna University, sir, because it will provide a lot of funds, and they might be used in research and development for further, sir, and it will also open gate for foreign students so that we can have cooperation with foreign countries. So I feel that this tag is necessary for Anna University.
And in last 2-3 weeks, there was a virus spreading all over. So
coronavirus.
Can you elaborate on?
Sir, it has it was found out in China, Wuhan region. This is a virus related to respiratory system, sir. Now it has been spreaded all over world, and WHO has also declared this as emergency in China, sir.
Is there any reported events in India?
Sir, till now there are no reporting, but the nurse from here has been in Saudi Arabia, I think, sir. They found out the virus strain in an Indian nurse.
From which place?
I think she is from Kerala, sir.
Yeah. And Tushar was talking about Australian bushfire, right? So what do you think this climate change can, whether it is going to totally destroy our world, or what we can do as a human being for this climate change?
Sir, definitely I myself witnessing the impacts of climate change, because we have a failure of monsoon and increasing temperature. India has felt one of the warmest year this time. So we are looking many impacts of the climate change. So definitely world nations have to be coordinately take measures, sir. Now they are tussling between developed and developing. It has to be resolved, and we have to take measures to reduce the carbon dioxide emissions, and we have to.
So what makes, who's the reason? What is the reason for climate change?
Sir, it's because of actually naturally there is a climate change in a limited scale, but now as a human being, we have fostered it through our vehicle usage and our industrial pollutions. So we are the reasons behind this.
You mean to say you don't need to go for any developmental activities?
Sir, no, sir. But we can go for sustainable development through using green energy, renewable energy, and we can minimize our usages, and we can implement recycle, reuse that policy. We can reduce these kind of things.
Since you are in UK club, that's what I was asking this question. So what kind of in a small scale, suppose if you put as a IAS officer in a district level, so what kind of initiative you can take regarding that?
So the first thing is, I will promote the public transport usage among the people. If that happen, we can reduce lot of car usage or bike usage by a single person. And the second thing is, I can make people to live a minimalistic life through recycle and reducing the resources used by them, sir. So we can reduce that. And the third thing would be make them first aware so that they will follow these rules and these things.
Okay, so you are from Pondruti, right?
Yes, sir.
So Pondruti Palaparam is very
famous. Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
Pondruti in Kallur district.
Yes, sir.
Kallur district faces a lot of disasters.
Yes, sir.
So can you tell some of the disasters in Kallur? Some main
Sir, I feel two disasters. One is the flood, and the second is cyclone. Every year we are prone to these two things, sir.
So, can you elaborate on maybe in your lifetime you have met some disasters, right?
Sir, in 2011, while I'm studying school time, I witnessed Thane Puyal, sir, which is one of the disastrous cyclone. Many of their livelihood has been destroyed by that cyclone. Lot of trees and farmers has been affected a lot because Panruti, the economy is dependent upon the cashew nuts and jackfruit. So entirely that economy is destroyed, and we itself have been without electricity for 15 more days, sir. And we are also not have drinking water, like that of issues we face.
Whether you think like the cyclone is mitigatable or manageable?
So I think it's manageable, sir. Because cyclone will happen, it's a natural phenomena, but we can mitigate with our precautionary and preventive measures.
What is the difference between mitigation and management?
So mitigation means we can stop the thing from happening, I feel, sir. Manageable means we can reduce the impacts from that thing.
Can you tell some one or two management activity for cyclone? Sir, from cyclone.
Sir, first the district administration may first pinpoint which are the area more prone to that thing, so that they can take the steps like having the rehabilitation center and the required facilities required for the people, so that at the time of cyclone they can have the people and they can provide their necessary needs. And the second thing is we have to make the citizens aware that what they can do at the time of disaster during cyclone. If they have been aware, they can save the coconut trees or they can save the cashew. Rather, they depend on entirely on governments.
State level political leader from your place.
Sir, the first Chief Minister of Madras Presidency, Mr. Subraya Reddy, is from Cuddalore district, sir.
Cuddalore district. From Panruti.
Presently, I am not aware.
First of all, I want to clarify whether Panruti is a place or Puducherry is a
place. Sir, Panruti is my father's place, sir. Puducherry, where my mother stayed, so I was born there.
Where is your father working?
He is working as health inspector in Kadamlio, near to Panruti.
For Tamil Nadu?
Yes, Tamil.
Your mother is working here?
Yes, sir.
Post office?
Yes, sir.
Role of post office in our society, can you tell us? Or significance of post office?
Sir, after the digitalization era, there might be feeling that post office has lost its relevance. But I feel that it plays important role in financial inclusion at present with Indian Postal Payment Bank, and also they are providing a best insurance RPLI, where many persons are able to get insurance. And the third thing, they are nowadays they are playing an important role in Aadhaar enactment, and they are also enrolling passport is happening there.
Still, it plays a major role.
Yes, sir.
In Puducherry, frequently we are seeing some news regarding the clashes between Chief Minister.
Yes.
Why? What's the reason?
Sir, unlike states, union territories are under the control of central government. They don't have any exclusive power as that of states. But Puducherry union territory is created with the legislature. So there is no clear demarcation in the constitution with regard to power between lieutenant governor and the elected governments, sir, so that since there is no clear-cut demarcation as that of states, the tussle is continuing.
Whenever there is a dispute between state and center, Supreme Court can be referred under which article?
Article 131,
sir. In the recent times, some happenings under Article 131
yes, sir. Has happened. Yes, sir. So Kerala government has chosen to approach the Supreme Court regarding the Citizenship Amendment Act. So they don't want to implement it.
Who is Greta?
So she is a climate change, she is an activist who working for a climate change.
So many people are working for the environment. Why is she popular?
So she is a young, she is a very young, and she even don't want to go to school. She thinks about the future that without a proper environment, we don't able to live. So she give important to the environment above her education.
You are right. Just to
yes.
We should be have editorials in our newspaper. Basic principles of capitalism teaches us that papers should be neutral or editorial other articles edit page, they are biased. Then,
sir, since we are a democratic country, each person has opinion to freely express their opinions. So editorial will provide a deep insights about the issues in many aspects. So I feel editorials will helpful in giving a various kind of opinions about issues.
Editorial gives one particular type of opinion.
Yes, sir.
It is not giving, editorial is not giving.
Yes, sir.
Versions.
But you, yes, sir. But each newspaper will favor various kind of.
So, to get a clear point, one has to read so many newspapers.
So definitely, sir, because each media is biased to some particular ideology, sir. So that person's opinion is expressed in editorials.
So you are interested in political science, so you are talking about ideologies. What type of republic are we?
So ours is democratic republic country where head of the state is elected.
Democratic republic.
Head of the state is elected by.
Right. What does our preamble say? What kind of democratic republic are we?
Socialistic, sovereign, secular democratic republic.
Socialistic.
Sovereign and. Secular Democratic Republic.
What do you mean by socialism?
Sir, it's an ideology which bases equality as an important virtue, sir. Where
some people are saying that socialism is totalitarianism. It is against democracy.
So there are tendency that who ruling that place, because why they are seeing it as a totalitarianism is it curtails one's liberty, sir. Because for achieving equality, we have to sacrifice some liberty of a person, sir, so that we can achieve equality. And also in social, in socialism.
Sorry.
A public government has been given a. Important role, sir. So if a person is not wise enough, the socialism can degrade to totalitarianism.
Yes, socialism and democracy are complementary to each other.
No, sir. Our India is following socialistic democratic socialism, sir. We are following a socialism pattern in economical aspects in some places, but we are we are providing a liberty for a person through fundamental rights, and we are.
What kind of economy are we having?
We have mixed economy, sir, where in some aspects consumers has been provided choices. In some areas like PDS system or in price control, government has been playing a role, sir.
Okay, some observations now. You are writing letters to editor. You have taken political science and international relations. When the honorable member asked you what are the major problems of the world, you correctly said that trade, China, America trade war. But when it came to India, with Malaysia, you didn't say that the trade aspect of it. Okay. That was expected.
Okay.
And when I asked you on this regional classification, you have not mentioned it. Okay. After I reminded you, then only you said. Okay. Then you need a little. Read a little more about it, because there may be a political science professor in the board.
Okay.
Political science psychology, there is generally these professors.
Okay.
So immediately you will know that your knowledge is not that deep, like political science students.
Okay.
So because you have taken political science, that they would ask constitutional questions like that. Like regarding 131. 131, you should read a little more also.
Okay.
He didn't ask you because you didn't go to that depth because we have no time. 131, Supreme Court has two judgments. State can come, state cannot come.
Okay.
So, how to reconcile this, that the state can come, now that is with a larger bench.
Okay.
So, because you are a political student, you have taken political science as an optional, that's why read little.
Okay.
Okay, because all the major issues are political science issues, constitutional issues.
Okay.
So, read.
Okay.
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 When the honorable member asked you on mitigation efforts, mitigation and adaptation.
Okay.
But what is your answer?
Mitigation. He asked mitigation or manageable.
Mitigation of cyclones. How do you mitigate?
So mitigation.
It's mitigation is preventing a thing.
Okay, sir.
Adaptation is adapting it after it has happened. So very clear about it.
Okay.
So what I am saying is, the macro view must be very clear.
Okay.
Like trade, as you asked. Now diplomacy is totally dominated by trade. See, why Imran Khan has said that nobody listens to us, everyone listens to India. Because India is a big market. That he has admitted several times.
Yes, sir.
Okay. And when it comes to Turkey, these two countries, as he said, they are against India's Kashmir policy and this CAA. Okay. But Turkey also, because two countries are involved, so read India's reaction to Turkey also.
Okay, sir.
Okay.
Yeah, this second time you are
going. Yes, sir.
What happened in the last time?
Interview score is less.
You apply for TNPSC?
Yes, sir.
You're in a.
Yes, sir. Their interview second slab they have given, sir.
Okay. Not selected or?
No, sir. 196th rank. So I
didn't. Anyway, as Far was mentioning about current topics, precious thing. The last time we discussed about your district.
Yes, sir. Lower. Yes, sir.
Still that holds the relevance.
Okay, sir.
So again, just go through it.
Okay, sir. Thank you.
120,
okay, sir.
20 years out or it's far.
Okay.
Political science, environment, both the all are interested in.
Okay.
Environment.
Okay, sir.
So your precise. You have to read more.
Okay, sir.
I am tempted to ask some questions when you are answering their questions.
Yes, sir. No time.
You are talking about the behavior of the people. You are talking about better monitoring of state machinery. Then naturally we tend to ask what are surveillance laws.
Okay.
Then it will lead to so many.
Okay.
This one, 31 Kerala, along with Kerala, I think Punjab also has challenged it.
I think Chhattisgarh
has also.
So now. Kerala.
Okay, sir.
Almost on the
question.
Sir. Yes, sir.
Why 131 is called original jurisdiction?
Sir, it's only Supreme Court can have that.
There are many other things also which originates in the Supreme Court. What are they?
Exclusive to
Supreme. Yes. What are the other things to which for which you have to go to Supreme Court only? Other cases are there.
Sir,
President, Vice President election.
Yes, sir.
Is there. Yes, sir. Then 32 writ petition.
Yes, sir.
That also Supreme Court only.
Okay, sir.
That in fact NIA was challenged. The constitution validity of NIA was challenged, I think, by Maharashtra.
Yes, sir.
So it's very, very tough times for the central state.
Okay, sir. Thank you, sir. Thank you.